all the way to the end. Any and every task that's given, I will do it.
Okay. All right. And why should we hire you?
I am more than what you put out in the application.
Right.
Okay, I will do above and beyond.
All right.
Again, I will exceed your expectations of me.
Wow.
And I promise you will never regret hiring me.
All right. Wow. All right. Come on.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay.
She's
not letting on kind of hectic there. Came in dressed all nice. She's ready. Okay, well, that's all I have to say for right now. You'll know within 24 hours whether or not you receive the job. You'll get a call regardless, and I thank you, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
All right.
So now the mandate. So you saw how she walked up in here. She's looking all nice, and she's ready with the right questions and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
So a mandate, I just want to read to you what a mandate is. It's an official order or commission to do something.
That's right.
The authority to carry out a policy or a course of action. There's a lot of mandates in the Bible, but the mandate that I'm going to focus on this morning, which Bishop was all in my message, I said, oh my goodness, I didn't even got to preach. He didn't preach the whole message, is evangelizing. Mark 6:15, which is my scripture. So wherever you go in the world, tell everyone about the good news.
My God.
That's what we're mandated to do. We're mandated to spread the good news, to spread the gospel. And why? You ask, why are we mandated to spread the good news?
Why?
It's in Acts 26:18. If you will open their eyes and turn them from darkness to light and from Satan's control to God's, then they will receive forgiveness for their sins and share amongst God's people who are made holy by believing in me. So how would someone know who God is if God is an unseen God? We can feel him, but we can't physically see him, so he sends us. He sends us. We are mandated to go out and be God's representatives.
All right.
But how are we representing him? If somebody looks at you right now, would they want the God that you represent?
My Lord.
By the way you talk, by the way you treat people, is that the God that you're introducing?
My mind.
Is he the real God? Do people want that God? So as we saw with Melinda, she was very eager to get this position. She was on her best behavior. She made sure she said all of the right things. She was dressed to impress, and her resume was impeccable. You know, we doctor up the resumes. I'm sorry, that's just me. This is a whole church. Y'all know y'all put some stuff on that resume that, you know,
true.
Come on, let's be honest. Your resume, I was the overseer of finances in the accounting department. Since you were a cashier, come on. But it's on the resume, and you act the part, right? Because you're eager to get the job, and we do what we gotta do and say what we have to say to get it.
Yes.
And we're like that when it comes to God.
Yes. All right.
Yes.
We're gung-ho. We're doing whatever it takes. Oh, God, pick me. I got this. I promise you that I'll be the one to go out. I'll be the one to help the homeless. I'll be the one to feed the hungry. That's what we all say in the beginning.
Right.
Come on.
But we forget the promises we made to God.
Come on.
All
right.
Like, God, if you do this, I'll do this.
Amen.
God, if you... Oh, that's just me. I'm the only one that promised God some stuff. Yeah. I remember the last time I was sitting in my cell in Nyanic. Yes, Nyanic. That was BC before Christ. Don't judge me. I was there often. Often they had a cell for me. I was sitting in my cell in 2001 on an attempted murder charge. No weapon. Not at all, but attempted murder. And I sat on my knees. I said, God, if you get... Mind you, I was out on three bonds.
Wow.
Right? I was out on three bonds.
Wow.
7 years minimum.
Wow.
They were like, no, you're laying down. I said, God. Oh, I knew God then. I knew God, Gabriel, Michael, Jesus, the Holy Spirit. Come on, let's be real. That's how we do. When we're in trouble, we're holy. I'm in a cell like, God, if you get me out of this cup. So I went to trial, and God did just that. He got me out of that. With all of that, with no jail time.
My God.
That is the God that we serve, because God looks at this. God looks at the heart. And he knew I was serious about it this time. But the thing about it is, we tend to want so much from God and tend to give God so less of us.
Yeah.
In the beginning, we're gung-ho, we're excited.
Welcome.
Welcome to New Beginnings Ministry. My name is Brother Andre. I want to invite you guys to come out and find the Word of God in this living place. It is living and it is active. If you come in here, listen to the Word and apply the Word, it will change your life. Jesus is going to come in with the rushing wind, like the Holy Spirit says, and change your life. Come in and find out for yourself. Don't only believe me, but try it for yourself. Bye.